let's talk about the Team USA Wrestling Men's Freestyle Team. This was a crazy couple of weeks with Final X, Final X Rutgers, Final X Lincoln, and what a great performance. First, I want to commend Flow Wrestling for putting on such a great show at all levels of the event. First of all, in Greco, then in women's freestyle, and in senior men's freestyle, it was a heck of a turnout, heck of an event, both of those, if you were watching. But let's talk about the senior men's team and what the potential team could look like, or what it does look like, and what they could do at the World Championships this September. The World Championships are this September 14th through the 22nd in Nur-Sultan, Kazakhstan. And this is such a exciting time to be a wrestling fan, and I think that Flow Wrestling really has brought up the level of encouragement and support behind Team USA, and there's just a great fan base right now. So first of all, at 57 kilos, we have Dayton Fix. Dayton Fix, of course, just beat Thomas Gilman, and I'm going to run down this lineup and tell you exactly who is on the team, who they beat, and you know where they're ranked in the world right now. So Dayton Fix, of course, that was a phenomenal match with him and Thomas Gilman. A lot of people were wondering why in that third match in Final X, why Thomas Gilman decided to shoot. He was up in criteria. He would have won the match if he didn't shoot. Well, listen, Thomas Gilman's always an aggressive guy. He's always going to be going after him. And who's to say that next year he's not competing again for an Olympic spot? And, you know, he'll be back. But Dayton Fix has a spot right now. He's going to do well in the world, although he is not ranked right now. We'll see how he does. Next up at 61 kilos, we have Tyler Graff. Tyler Graff over Joe Colon. Joe Colon right now is actually third in the world. He took bronze last year. He's ranked number three officially, but now that he got beat out, Tyler Graff, who just beat out the bronze medalist, has a strong shot at placing at Worlds, I believe. And at 65 kilos, this was, of course, the talk of the town. It was the talk of both Final X events because it was Yianni Diakomihalis versus Zain Retherford. I mean, what a crazy couple of matches. And, you know, it was unfortunate to see the way it went down, whether you're a Penn State fan or just a wrestling fan in general, you know, or a Yianni fan, you're especially upset. But right now where that stands, and if you're not caught up to date on this, basically what happened is Yianni probably should have had a take that. It was a crazy situation that happened in the match. People were arguing that Yianni and Zain, you know, where the call was, where the challenge was, and Cornell's coaches are actually protesting that match right now. I don't think that this is going to result in any sort of change. And I think that right now it's officially set in stone. Zain is on Team USA. Now, Yianni will come back next year and wrestle for that Olympic spot. And that's great because he beat the number one ranked guy in the world right now, Puniat, beat the streets. So Zain now, even though he's lost to Yianni before, he beat him. And I think he has a strong shot at, you know, winning a world title, which is going to be pretty exciting come September. At 70 kilos, we have James Green over Ryan Deacon. And what I have to say about that first match, you know, James Green, he tacked Deacon in about like 18 seconds. It was, you know, he had a nice leg lace on Deacon, shot in, got a nice leg lace, and just rolled him through. Got the tack. Phenomenal job. At 70 kilos. At 74, Jordan Burroughs versus Imar. Now, this was a heck of a series. Went to three matches because Imar took that second match. And Imar almost had that first match. And I think, you know, really what happened here is Burroughs was close to missing weight. And, you know, he's going to do everything he can to make weight. He made weight in the last couple of minutes, which was pretty crazy that, you know, he would be that close. But anyway, he you know, came out strong against Imar, but Imar had a game plan. And, you know, it worked in the first two matches. And then in the third match, Burroughs just came alive, took it to Imar, and really just showed that, you know, he deserves that world spot. Burroughs right now is actually ranked third in the world. He had a bronze medal last year, and he's definitely looking for a gold this year. And I think you know, in my opinion, I think he's going to get it at 79 kilos. Now, this is an interesting story. We'll talk about this in a little bit, but Kyle Dake versus Alex Deringer, this match did not happen yet. It's actually delayed because of Kyle Dake's injury. So we'll get to that in a little bit. But at 86 kilos, Pat Downey has a spot, of course, because David Taylor was injured. This would have been an exciting match, and although I think David Taylor would have got the spot, would have ultimately won it, you never know. And that's what's pretty exciting is because with these spots, these guys are such top-tier guys that you don't know what's going to happen. And that's what I love about this level of wrestling is because these guys are always going at it and you don't know who's going to win. But Pat Downey has a spot. He's representing Team USA. And at 92 kilos, we have Jaden Cox, who was the returning world medalist, world gold medalist, world champion, Jaden Cox. He, of course, beat out Bo Nickel, which, you know, Cox just looked a little bit bigger and a little bit more in control than Nickel was. Bo's coming off, he hasn't really wrestled a lot of freestyle, but I think Bo will be in the back next year to, you know, for the Olympic trials. At 97 kilos, Kyle Snyder over Kyvan Gadsden. This was a two-match series, and Kyle Snyder just looked really on top of him. He ended up getting the tech in the second match. Looked very, very strong. Kyle Snyder is ranked number 2 in the world currently. And, of course, he's looking to beat the Russian to become a world champion this September. At 125 kilos, Nick Gwizdowski is the returning bronze medalist, and he's currently ranked, actually, I don't think he's even ranked in the world right now, but he beat Gable Stevenson, and he looked like he deserved that spot. He's a big guy, monstrous guy, and he's also looking for another world medal to qualify that way for the Olympics next year. And that's a very exciting Team USA.